Libra, and welcome back to the channel. Today, we are going to go over your reading for February. Let's get started. The first card you get is the Nine of Swords, and I feel like you're starting the month expecting news or looking for news. For others, I feel like this is you charging ahead, trying to create results on something that has been feeling stagnant. In your blockage position, you have the Fool. And I feel like there is a new start that you've been wanting, and for some reason there are delays. Especially with that Knight of Swords there, it looks like you are trying to push through these delays and get results quickly. In your foundation, you have the Moon. So there is a lot of stuff that is hidden from you right now. And you're desperately needing answers. You need to see changes. Trust the process. You had the Emperor. This could have been you being the authority in your life, or you could have been dealing with some sort of oppressive person, like a boss or a parent, a spouse, a friend, whatever the case may be. What's coming towards you? Is the King of Swords, and this is you being very logical and swift in your actions, just like that Knight of Swords. You are seeking truth this month. In your near future, you have the Ace of Cups, so there is an opportunity coming in. For some, this could be love. For others, it could be a job. It could be the change that you seek. These could be the answers that you are looking for, but the opportunity is on the horizon. Inwardly, you have the Four of Swords. You've desperately been needing time away, time off, and rest. This could indicate you've been having restless nights, being stressed, overthinking, anxiety, whatever the case may be, but you desperately need it to be more peaceful so that you can get rest. In your environment, you have the Wheel of Fortune. The wheel is turning in your favor. Peaceful times are ahead of you, and these answers that you're actively seeking will be coming to you. In your hopes and fears, you have the Three of Wands. I see this as you hoping for this change, hoping to make changes, hoping to make a change in your career, possibly. Being that is a wand, and it looks like you're waiting on the perfect time. Remember, there is never an absolutely perfect time. You must take action when you are intuitively prompted to do so. In your outcome position, you have the Star. There is a renewal of hope and faith here. This may be after getting that news. It renews your hope in something that you've been working towards. And as you can see, you are moving into the light. Next, we have your Oracle cards. As you can see, between the Star and the Moon, you are moving out of the darkness and into the light. Next, we have your Oracle cards. In your past position, you have something that you were looking forward to, and maybe it didn't work out the way you had intended it to, or in the time that you intended it to. And now you're stuck in this moon phase, feeling left out in the dark. In your favor. There are things that kind of just click, and I feel like that is coming towards you. There is an opportunity. I feel like this means that what is meant to be will be. The next card you get is fear, and I do feel like this is because of that moon. You are so left in the dark and can't see more than 10 steps ahead of you. You're not sure what to expect or what this news will bring, but you are hoping that this works out in your favor. And with that Wheel of Fortune, I do believe this will work out in your favor, and that's why you're going to be helpful in the near future. The next card you get is Full Moon in Aries. A fiery climax approaches. I do feel like your emotions have been running high, and once you get this news, things are going to start moving again. I don't necessarily get that it's going to be like a conflict, but I do feel like your emotions will be running high with this one. Because of all that anxiety, you're finally going to get that release, and hope will be renewed again. The next card you get is Full Moon. Surrender to the Divine. I feel like this is, again, saying that what is meant for you will never pass you by. Listen to your intuition. Get in touch with nature. Relax. Do whatever it is you can to help you become calm. You need to relax. The information you seek is on its way. Next, we have your rune. This is the rune of defense. And for some reason, I'm getting the sense that you've been feeling the need to defend yourself against something. Possibly something happened. Maybe it wasn't necessarily your fault. This could be you blaming yourself. This could be other people blaming you. But you're feeling defensive. You're feeling sensitive. But know that the answers you need are coming. Try to relax. Thank you for sitting with me through this reading. If this reading resonated with you, or you like this style reading, please consider liking, subscribing, commenting down below. Thank you, and have a beautiful day.